Welcome to Enoch's Engineering. I'm Alan. Today in the workshop I'm making a anvil extension for my dial indicator. It's one of these plunger type indicators and this is the extension I made. And the reason why I made the extension is I couldn't get enough travel on the indicator when it was in a block on my lathe. Another thing I want to mention is thread cutting on the lathe. Now I've come across a program that Evan sent me that is made for thread cutting on the South Bend lathe and the Boxford. It covers about 30 different types of lathe, whether you have the gears or the Norton gearbox, whether it's metric or imperial. And I've found this useful because you could put a thread that you want to cut, put the details in, and it will calculate the gears that you need to cut this thread. Now that's useful if you've lost a gear or you've broken a gear and you still want to cut a certain thread. It'll work out different combinations with different gears. Now on a Boxford chart you'll just get one set of gears that you can use and that's it. But this could work out up to 10 different types of gear trains. So it will be useful if you have lost some gears or broken them, or even if you're trying to cut a metric thread on an imperial lathe or imperial thread on a metric lathe and you just wanted to know what gears you needed to do that. So have a look at the program. I'll put the link at the beginning of the video in the video description. So let's go into the workshop and see how we make the anvil for this dial indicator. This is how I measured the pitch of the thread. These are Moore & Wright thread pitch gauges and this is for a 6BA thread. And when I put the pitch gauge onto the screw, it fits okay. So that's why I decided to use a 6BA thread on the end. Set my compound slide over about 3 degrees. With a small file, I just want to put a radius on the end. Turn that round in the chuck. The first thing I'm going to do is cut this excess off. Use a saw for that because it's so thin. I think we're in for some rain. Thank you. 0.1105. I selected a BA die, and this is a 6BA. It's the nearest thread I can find to the dial indicator thread. I know it's not right because when it goes most of the way in, it starts to lock up, so it's probably 90% there, but I don't know what they use on a Beatty dial indicator. I've been looking on the internet, it could be UNF, BA or metric, depending on what indicator it is. The nearest to it is 6BA, which I will use on this. Right, I'm fitting my steering wheel in the headstock at the back, so I can turn the headstock. Just tightens up with a hand screw. Then I can move the headstock. I've taken the tool post off. And now I've put the 6BA die in the holder. Put that in the tailstock. Should push up against the face. That's there. Now what I want to do is turn the die around so that the thread goes up to the face. Let's take it out, put it in backwards. Now I've seen a problem already. Because this die is recessed on the back, it'll touch the chuck jaw, so I'll have to bring the part a bit further out in the chuck. So that should be able to go back in there. Pick up on the thread. Okay, it's up to the face. Just use the file to clear that phrase off.
That should fit. Now I have an extension anvil. Now on the Boxford lathe, the saddle has a pad on the front area. This pad here originally was machined and it was painted over, but that is flat and square, and you can use that as a stop. Just clamps onto the V, holds the dial indicator, or I can change the dial indicator for a solid stop, or I've also made a turret with different lengths of bar so you can have different settings if you're doing a production run or something like that. And when the dial indicator anvil hits the pad, the dial indicator will start to move, so you can set that to the depth that you want. You can see with the ball type anvil fitted that the saddle hits the block. The dial indicator only goes around about 7 times and then it stops when the saddle hits the block. With the extension fitted, it will rotate ...25 revolutions, and even then the saddle is still clear of the block.
Here are some of the anvils that I've collected or made over the years, all for different job.
Oh well, there's a selection of anvils that fit the dial indicator. I hope that was useful. I hope you enjoyed it, and we'll see you next time on Enuts Engineering.